Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and the difference between FAT32, exFAT, and NTFS in less than 5 minutes. So let's get started. Now, file systems. All three of these guys are considered a file system. So what is a file system? It provides a way of organizing a drive, specifies how data is stored on the drive, and what types of information can be attached to the file, such as file names, permissions, and other attributes. Now, again, there are three file system types, and one is the NTFS, which is the new technology file system, FAT32, which is the file allocations table, and exFAT, which is another newer model of the FAT32, which is the extended file allocation table. Now, NTFS. NTFS is a modern file system used by Windows for its system drive and for non-removable devices. NTFS has a file size and partition size limits that are huge enough that you won't run up against them at all. They're pretty big. Now, it supports file permissions for security, a change journal that can help quickly recover errors if your computer crashes, shadow copies for backups, which is, I love shadow copies, encryptions, data quota limits, and hard links. Windows partition must be on NTFS for it to install correctly. It works with all Windows versions, but read-only with Mac and Linux distribution. FAT32. It's the oldest of the three file systems available within Windows. It was a replacement of the FAT16 file system used for MS-DOS and for Windows 3 time. Wow, that's a long time. Now, flash drives that are purchased will often come formatted to FAT32. Now, it's great for compatibility across many old and modern computers with a USB port. So that basically means you can have a USB flash drive with FAT32 format and use it within the Mac or Linux environment. Now, individual files on a FAT32 drive can't be over 4 gigs in size. That's the limitation. FAT32 partitions must also be less than 8 terabytes. Now, the FAT32 is a great file system for USB flash drives and external hard drives if you're okay with the limitation of 8 terabytes and also saving 4 gigs files inside of them. One of the bad things about the FAT32, it lacks permissions and other security features that the NTFS has. That's the reason why you don't see Windows installed anymore within the FAT32. It works with all versions of Windows, Macs, and Linux, which is a plus. For the exFAT, again, it's optimized for flash drives. It's designed to be a lightweight file system, such as the FAT32. Has a very large limit of files and partition size, and allows you to store files larger than 4 gigs, which is a huge improvement from the FAT32. Right? That's pretty cool. One of the cool things about the exFAT file system, it offers full read and write support within the Macintosh environment, which are great. Overall, guys, that is the difference between FAT32, exFAT, and NTFS in less than 5 minutes. If you have any questions or comments, leave them right below, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.